and a new center as we just take stock of the 12 days into the new year 2018 here on KTN News Center. What is the state of the nation like? What are some of the things Kenyans are grappling with? What are some of the things that have made big headlines 12 days into the new year? I want to introduce my guest in studio real quick. We have Ruth Ambogo sitting on my immediate right here. She's the director of Young Kenya Women Leaders. And Thank you. Also have Samson Cherargei. He's the senator for Nandi County. I must say it's a privilege to have young panelists today. Thank you very much for joining me here on KTN News Center. I would like us to start with, how do you assess some of the big things you've seen since we began the year? What are some of the highlights for you?
Personally, as a young person who's very interested in women's participation in the political space, I think one of the biggest things I have seen this year is the first, announcement of the first cabinet, which basically saw the very first five women who are in the previous cabinet not being retained. So for me, that makes big news, given that I have an interest in women being involved in politics and leadership and the governance space. And of course, secondly, we are seeing kids are going back to school. We had the promise of a free education, and we still have stories on media of students who are unable to make it to school because of school fees. So there's a lot that's going on in the education sector that gets us very interested, or gets me very interested. Yeah. And the rollout, or rather the testing of the new education system that is supposed to be implemented as well, that is news for me. Mm-hmm. And finally, I think the fact that now we are going back to hustling for food, literally. Yeah, so for
Hunger
me,
these
three seem to have caught
you
my attention.
The fundamental things that I want us to talk about on this show today, but let's hear from the senator.
Thank you for having me, and Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you, too.
I want to say this year it is good, at least politics is now over. Mm-hmm. I think Kenyans
are. Is it really over?
It's over because elections are over. Of course, politics will always be the different dimensions of politics. But what I say is that at least now Kenyans can concentrate on building the nation after a very protracted electioneering period. You remember last year we did have two presidential elections, which were so unique for this country and so many countries. So it is important. I think what we are seeing are also reforms in the education sector. Are now settling in of cabinets, among other issues that of importance and concern to Kenyans. We have so many plans because also the business world is excited that the elections are over. At least now they can do their business with a lot of predictability. And I think secondly is that Uhuru Kenyatta is settling in for his second term, which is he's building his legacy. And also it is important that he's also trying to assemble his team that will continue to transform the agenda and ensure that going forward is that is putting in men and women that will also shape and build a legacy that is he will leave after 2022, coming in mind that as constitutionally mandated, he's serving his last term of tenure within the 10 years that has been provided by the constitution.
Let's begin from where you just left, leave it from, the nominations to the cabinet. She says she's very disappointed with the number of women that seemingly have been ousted from that particular space, but there are reports of a fallout already between the president and his deputy over these names.
No, as far as I know, media, of course, must look for a good headline to sell.
I don't think there is a potential fallout.
There is no potential fallout because even if you say six cabinet secretaries were retained, we have the constitution allows the president to appoint up to 22. So we still have around 11 or even how many, around 12, that has even almost 11, 12 that are still to be appointed. So the issue, in fact, if you had, I think the presidency clarified the following day that no CS has been sacked. They are still in power. So I want to say the issue, whether women or not have been retained, is here nor there, because they can still, and under, I think 22, you still have around 7 to 6 women to fill the required mandatory gender. Number two, I think we should also give the presidency time. The fact that some of the ministers were retained does not mean there is a fallout. You had a deputy president said in a funeral in Eastern that the person who is solely allowed by the constitution to do nominations and being vetted by the parliament and then being appointed by the president is the president himself. So as far as I know, and I being a member of Jubilee, there is no fallout between the deputy president and I think it's just a creation.
It'll be interesting to hear what Ruth has to say, but I want us to take a quick break. We'll be back with more here as we discuss some of the major headlines as we take a look at the state of the nation 12 days into the new year of 2018. Let's take a quick break here on News Center. Don't go too far. We still have a lot more lined up for you.